Chandrasekhar, member of the parliament in Rajya Sabha, to talk more about this story. Really, Rajiv, the big question, I know everybody's been talking about a JPC for a while now, but will a JPC really fix the problem, fix this problem of this 2G scam?
You know, this is a cabinet form of government that we run in India. There's a system of checks and balances of a cabinet secretary who heads the bureaucracy. There's a principal secretary in the prime minister's office. That whole system of checks and balances seems to have collapsed in this particular instance, where a minister and a few bureaucrats and a few corporates were able to swindle such a large amount of money from the exchequer. So I think the JPC is the only way to really go into what are the systemic issues within the government that caused it to collapse and create such a complete absence of oversight and an absence of checks and balances. Because in our democracy and in this form of a parliamentary system of government, there has to be checks and balances to prevent rogue ministers and rogue bureaucrats from running amok, as we saw recently.
But Rajiv, you spoke about checks and balances, systemic issues that in a sense need to be fixed. Do you fear, but then, that few months down the line, 2G will be a forgotten scam and this JPC would end up as just another parliamentary committee?
And you know, that's a legitimate concern. I think, you know, I'm optimistic, I won't bet on it happening just because we wish for it to happen. I think we have got here so far, Sandeep. Let's be very clear how we got here, how we reached here. We reached here and we are at this point because the media played a very important role, the Supreme Court played a very important role, and a number of public interest litigants like Dr. Swami and Prashant Bhushan went in there fearlessly and challenged the government and the status quo. So this did not happen because the system of checks and balances in the government kicked into action. This happened because a number of non-government actors, including the media, chose to involve themselves and in determining the truth. And if that pressure and that spotlight of these actors remains for the next few months, I have no doubt that the JPC, while it may have a typical tendency to become political, will focus on the real questions and get the real answers, and the real questions being, as I said, to do with the systemic breakdown and the breakdown of government.
Okay, so you're hoping for some real answers at least. Rajiv, even as we debate about this, of course, we've been picking up from CBI sources that big corporation heads are unlikely to be questioned. Do you believe that big fish could get away in this 2G scam probe?
You know, I hope not. I hope this is really a time for India to show that we are a country where the laws and rules apply to everybody, big, small, famous name, not so famous name. And I hope, I really hope. And the reason for my hope and optimism is the fact that the Supreme Court is supervising the CBI. And the Supreme Court's oversight of the CBI is fairly total, and to the extent that they have said that the charge sheet that has to be filed by the CBI will have to be vetted by the Supreme Court. So I think that should give us some hope and confidence that the typical scenario in India, which is that the big fish always get away, may not play itself out again this time, and all of the perpetrators will be in the net of justice and law.
All right, Rajiv Chandrasekhar, thanks for joining in on the show with your thoughts really on the constitution of JPC and of course whether the big fish will get away. Let's do a quick check on crude prices, which of course skyrocketed more than 7% in early trade on concerns of growing tensions in Libya.